Hi, I'm Erik Berkness, a researcher at the University of Minnesota, currently working with Dr. Cindy Tong in the Department of Horticultural Science. Over the last 50 years, our climate in the upper Midwest has become increasingly wet, with heavier rainfall events occurring in the early spring when farmers need to access their fields, which often delays planting. One solution we wanted to explore for mitigating early spring rain was to prepare vegetable beds in the fall and use a cover crop between the beds to absorb excess rainfall.
So most of the farms, fruit and vegetable farms in Minnesota, are smart acreage. So we're gearing this project towards our lovely Minnesota farmers. And so we're thinking small plots. But it could be used in any size acreage where people are making raised beds. So making raised beds in the fall is not a new technique. Farmers have been doing this in other states, including Wisconsin, for years. What's different about our project is that we're using rye cover crop to allow us to get into the field when it's soppy in the spring and transplant.
For the past 2 years, we have been trialing this practice at the St. Paul campus and the Southern Research and Outreach Center in Waseca. We also had a farmer collaborator in Aiken, Minnesota, trial the method in 2022. We prepare raised beds and lay drip irrigation tape and plastic mulch over each bed in late September. We then plant a cover crop between the beds. In our trials, we have done this by broadcast seeding by hand and raking the seed in. Our farmer collaborator has also used this method in his trials. We've compared the use of rye, vetch, and a combination of rye and vetch, landscape fabric, and bare soil between rows. Behind me are the prepared beds for our final year of the trial. Here's what we've learned in this trial so far. Rye cover crops seem to be the most effective at absorbing spring rain. In our trials, using rye allowed us to enter fields to transplant onions in early May when fields were still wet. How can growers use this practice successfully? We've learned the following tips in our 3 years trialing this system. Number one, cover crop seeding date. Late September or very early October has worked well for our trials in St. Paul and Waseca. The Midwest Cover Crop Council's cover crop decision tool can help you to decide the best seeding date for your area. Number two, seeding rate, 75 to 100 pounds per acre or 1.5 to 3 bushels per acre has worked well in our trials with winter rye. Number three, seeding method. We've broadcast seeded and raked in our plots. Planting between raised beds may prevent you from using tools like grain drills. And finally, number four, spring management of cover crops. Cut at heading, field crews have used implements such as brush hogs. Alternatively, it can be periodically mowed.
I'm Erik Heimark. I'm the owner of Maple Ridge Produce. We have a small vegetable farm. We practice mostly organic practices, and we're on about 6 acres. This is my pumpkin patch. It's about a half acre here. My farm's pretty small. I'm only on about 12 acres and just about 2 of it at the home farm is arable, which we already got tilled up. So I have to find other plots of land to grow all my vegetables on. This plot of land here happens to be really, really clayey soil. And so it's been a struggle oftentimes to get in on this field early on. So I thought I'd participate in this rye study to see if the rye could help improve a little bit of that soil moisture and if I could get in a little earlier this year. So last fall, we tilled this field. I put in some manure and some peat and rice hulls to add some organic matter into this field. And then I was able to come back with my mulcher bed shaper and lay the plastic and irrigation tubing. So we seeded our rye, I think around early October, probably around the 10th of October, which is pretty late, but it came up just fine. We had 2 to 3 inches of growth before the first snow came down. So I was pretty impressed by that. And just having the fall seeding was really good for my management because it made me prep the field in the fall. And then this spring, it was one less thing to do. I really like that model. I'm going to try doing more of that, where I'm doing more of the fall prep, and take one thing off my plate in that early wet spring. Sometimes it's too wet to even do this, so it was nice to have it all done before the season began. The intent was to help dry this kind of mucky soil out, so I could get in a little earlier with the planting. It happened to be a pretty dry spring this spring and pretty late. We had about 4 feet of snow on the ground until late April, and we weren't even able to see our fields till early May. So I don't know if it was just the dry year or if it's the rye that was pulling the moisture out and allowed me to get in a little earlier, but I would certainly do this again. This year I'm planting pumpkins, which normally I don't put in till mid-May anyway. And this year it had to be pushed back till early June. The concern I have is I like putting landscape fabric between my rows when I have pumpkins and squash and melons because it keeps the fruit really clean. My original intent was to kind of flatten this down and kind of have that straw type bed from crimping. With all the other stuff we had in the spring, we decided to just give it a mow because it was faster and easier than walking it all down. That's pretty much the only concerns I have. My fruit won't be as clean, and it might be a little bit hard to get some of the rye down along the edges. But otherwise, I think it's a good trade-off with the biological material I'm putting in, so I'm okay with it. The other advantage of the rye cover crop is that oftentimes if you do have a wet year and you're using the landscape fabric, it holds a lot of water under there. It gets pretty squishy, especially when you're trying to drive over it with a tractor or something and a water wheel. You can get stuck pretty easy. I think the rye would allow some of that water to get consumed and not be trapped under. So there's another advantage for this over landscape fabric. Next year, I want to use this same infrastructure to plant brassicas. And I like to get those in a little earlier, early May, late April sometimes, if it's like cabbages. And this will be ready to go. I'm going to do the same thing with the rye, and I think hopefully it'll do that same trick where it'll pull some of that moisture out and allow me to get my machines in here a little earlier than I would otherwise. So I'm happy with the results. I'm going to keep doing this year after year. So I think especially in this field, it's real important for me to have something like rye or some sort of cover crop pulling up that excess moisture in the clay soil, as well as just adding some of that biological material back in, helping it drain a little bit better, and really kind of converting this field from a hay pasture into something I can use for vegetables and for the future to come.